I'm Gordon Ramsay. Ask me anything. Regarding food, what guilty pleasure do you have that most people would be shocked at? Fast food fries, frozen fish sticks, etc. Mine is spaghetti in a can. It's repulsive and I know I shouldn't eat it, but I can't help it. Well, first of all, you need help. Spaghetti in a can. That kind of shit we grew out of on our 8th birthday. I still remind my mum that she taught me how to spell with alphabetical spaghetti in a can. You need help, big time. My go-to sort of fast food snack, it would have to be In-N-Out Burger. Oh my god, honestly, it is, when I eat double doubles. I'm terrible. And I always bring it back on the airport. When I'm flying from LA to London, I'll sneak it into the first class lounge at BA. My question, outside of your own restaurants, where are some of your favorite places to eat? What dishes do you order? I've become a big fan of Vietnamese and Cambodian food, because they cook with very little dairy. So everything was tasty, but incredibly healthy at the same time. Great use of spice, broth, pork, a way of eating well but also just on the cusp of trying to stay healthy at the same time. So, you know, when I travel across the US, I always try to get off the sort of main foodie, the main sort of high streets, and get into little foodie quarters. If it's South New Orleans, or Austin, Texas, I'm going for the latest little thing that's just opened. So I'm pretty low-key like that. I like going into some sort of off-the-beaten-track areas. Do you have any food recommendations for a college student on a budget? I would recommend that you get adventurous with pulses, chickpeas, beans, lentils. And you know, cooking these is incredible. Brown rice. Phenomenal. You don't need expensive proteins. Just make them incredible with how you cook them, or prepare them. A pressure cooker is a great way of making these foods go a long way, is to cook them deliciously. Chilies, garlic, definitely. Have you ever literally gotten sick from a horrible hotel in Hotel Hell? EHM, you know, sometimes it doesn't happen until 2 to 3 days later. No, I've never really got sick, but I was in a hotel last year in Vermont, and I didn't realize, until I got home, that I caught nits in the hotel. Yeah. And I did something really bad, because I thought it was my daughter. I thought it was my youngest daughter, Matilda, and then it turns out it was me with the nits. So I had my hair checked by my wife Tara, and I traced it back to the pillowcase in Vermont. So I apologize to Matilda. Because, you know, she's young and quite often kids get nits. And then my wife said, listen, you're wrong. Tilly didn't give you nits. Ridiculous. My question is this, how do you feel about being a meme on the internet? Oh, gosh. I don't really get a chance to sort of look at the internet. Do you know what? I love that level of connection, and I try to show as much as I can, who I'm with, where I am, and giving people inspiration. So I don't really think of myself as a phenomenon on the internet. I'm a cook, who happens to be the luckiest cook in the world. Gordon, how do you like your eggs? I have to say, scrambled, over a slice of sourdough bread that has been grilled, and then sort of doused with Worcestershire sauce. Now scrambled eggs, I did a video a few years back with my youngest, Tilly, showing how to make scrambled eggs, and I think it has 10 to 11 million hits. And the nice thing about scrambled eggs is, that they don't have to just be breakfast, you can have them in the evening, with some nice mushrooms, some tomatoes. You can have them as a snack at midnight, or at 5 o'clock in the afternoon. What is the best meal you have ever had? And what about the worst? Well, negative, the worst meal? There's been too many of them to tell you about, because the last 10 years, working on kitchen nightmares, I've eaten a lot of crap. I think I've drank about 3.5 liters of Pepto-Bismol. And in terms of, you know, good meals, I had an incredible meal at the Black Liquor Market in Studio City. The most amazing scotch eggs, deviled eggs, and then these short ribs that were braised in beer. Incredible, just incredible. What's your favorite Disney movie? My favorite Disney movie, EHM, come on. Seriously? It has to be Ratatouille. Good afternoon, chef. Do you have a favorite cocktail? I have an amazing cocktail, which, you know, we're in Atlantic City currently, because we just launched the Gordon Ramsay Pub and Grill here, which is where we're calling from now. It's with Tanqueray Gin, and it's called, Wake Up You Donkey. I mean, ha 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 ha, it is incredible. And also, it's quite sort of spicy and fragrant, and it's absolutely delicious. Is there any food that you won't even try? Ehm, any food I won't even try? I think, being a chef, the first thing that I set out to do was to make sure that I almost got to taste every ingredient anywhere in the world. I wanted to learn so much about ingredients that I'd never know what not to do with an ingredient. So I'm an open book. Whether it's a beating cobra heart from a snake in Cambodia, or a deep-fried tarantula, or a beef Wellington, I'll eat absolutely anything. The only thing I draw the line at, Victoria, is eating overcooked food. There is nothing worse than an overcooked Brussels sprout. The smell is disgusting. Hey Gordon, what did you have for breakfast, mate? Hehe. Everyone thinks I have a glamorous breakfast, like a full English or eggs Benedict. I keep it simple, because it reminds me of my mum. So I keep it simple, porridge, which is oatmeal. But growing up in Stratford-upon-Avon, we kept it very simple, just oatmeal with water, salt, and oatmeal, because my dad said it would put hair on your bollocks. It's really weird hearing you say the word bollocks, Victoria. The night before, put 3 to 4 bananas in the oven on a pilot light. And the next day, squeeze the bananas into almond milk, bring it to a boil, then add the oatmeal and dried cranberries, and you'll have the most amazing oatmeal for breakfast. Hi chef, are there any really strange food combinations that you enjoy? I had an amazing doubled pork chop with rhubarb. Now rhubarb is something we literally eat with desserts, but this dish was incredible. It was in Spain. It was a doubled pork chop that had been slow roasted over an open pit fire with rhubarb. Absolutely delicious. This was one of my mates that was trying to show off cooking in his back garden in Spain when we were out filming for Kitchen Nightmares. I didn't think it was going to work, to be honest. And then when I started tasting, I thought, shut. This is delicious. To questions, you obviously have a talent for witty insults. Do they come naturally, or do you think about them and then say to yourself, I'm gonna use this one next time I get angry? Also, after watching your show, I want to try jelly deal. I'm going to London in a few days. Any recommendation about where to have it? Heh. Witty insults? Ehm, it just happens sort of spur of the moment. I see red, I get frustrated, I'll let it go. I'm not very good at editing myself. I have to get things off my chest. If there's one thing my mum taught me, it's speak your mind, be firm, get things off your chest. I think it's a good way to work, and quite healthy to have that attitude. Do I think about it previously? No, they just come to me in a flashpoint. And sometimes even I sit back and think, did I just say that? And then jelly deals, you've got to go to the East End of London and get the most amazing malt vinegar. They're very healthy, packed with protein, and bloody delicious. And the River Thames now, in London, is teeming with eels. So some of the best eels in the world now are from London. They're delicious. Earlier in your career, did anyone handling the media aspect ever try to convince you to change your persona? Do you swear, just as much in everyday life? Please say yes. I've never really worried about the sort of media profile. Early on in my career, I'm a chef. So I, you know, we don't get taught how to handle the media properly. And as you can probably understand, chefs when they start out make some pretty big mistakes in terms of saying things in the heat of the moment that get taken out of context. But I've always said that's passion. Do I swear? 2 weeks ago, I was at a parents' meeting for my school. And my daughter said, Daddy, please don't embarrass me. So I get to the school and the first thing that happens, there's all these mums and dads there, and all the teachers are there, with the names on the table, and I see the headmistress, and my daughter Holly was there, and it's incredible. I went straight up to the headmistress, and asked for a selfie, which I thought was ducking brilliant. My daughter dived under the table in embarrassment, but it just broke the ice. These things are just so formal. And the headmistress said, oh my lord, I've never had a selfie before. What do we do? So I said, put your head up and ducking smile. I tweeted it out. God bless her. Hey Gordon, big fan. I'm genuinely curious, how the hell do you manage your time? You are everywhere. You have at least 200 shows, a family, restaurants, etc. How do you balance all that? I multitask very well. And I'm never in one place too long. I think now with, you know, my own production company, I'm very lucky the schedule works around my diary. I work my ass off, you know, 15, 16 hours a day. I quite enjoy the time difference when I finish. For instance, last night we were taping MasterChef until 9 or 10 PM at night. I'll have a quick bite to eat, and then I'll call the UK at midnight, because come midnight LA time, West Coast time, it's 8 o'clock in the morning. I'll say good morning to the kids, I'll catch up with my business in London, and then from 2 to 5 o'clock, I sleep, get up, go to the gym, and then start my day again. So that's my daily slog. So I stand by my convictions. When I opened up the restaurant, Gordon Ramsay, back in September 1998, I decided I was going to work my ass off. My flagship restaurant in Chelsea has never been open on a Saturday and Sunday. It's never been open on a weekend. Because I thought, if we are going to do this, I'd like to do this properly. So my staff needs time off. So I work hard, but I give myself time off on the weekend. I cut it off and power down for 48 hours.